Zach, starting off, we asked Tab this, but 48 hours after the LAFC game, what have you guys seen from that game now that you've had a chance to digest it a little bit, and what's the approach going into the Portland game?
I think first and foremost, we have to be a little bit disappointed with how the result went. We never want to give up a lead, especially one that was two goals. I think there are definitely a lot of positives to take from it. Ultimately, LAFC is one of the best teams in the league, so taking a point from them can be viewed as a positive, but I think that we definitely want to build on some of the things that we saw and play a little bit more of a complete game. And I think that there's definitely room to improve going into Portland and a winnable 3 points and hopefully a situation where we can move to the top of the group.
Thanks for that. We'll go ahead and start with questions from the reporters. We'll start with Hector Zapata. Hector, you should be able to unmute yourself and go ahead.
Hey, Zarek, how you doing? My question is, after you guys saw the game, you analyzed what happened, especially in the second half. What are some of the things that Coach Ramos emphasized that going into that next game against Portland?
I think there's a few points in which we can emphasize going into the next game against Portland. One of those is just communication. A lot of times when there's moving parts on the field, it's difficult to navigate situations, but the easiest ways to communicate, whether you're passing on runners, whether you're staying with the runner, or whether there's quick free kicks or set pieces and things like that, communication is massive, and we can always improve on that, and that's something that we can take from game to game. Obviously, there's individual moments that will be a little bit more specific to LAFC. They pack a lot of numbers centrally, so we have to make sure we get to the ball and get their heads down. Obviously, if you get pressure on good players, but don't get close enough to potentially make them make a decision, then it becomes easy. And with guys like Valeri and Blanco, who I know well, we have to make sure that we close them down and not give them as much space and time to make decisions because they're good enough to punish you.
Thanks, Hector. We'll go next to Garrett Heinrich. Go ahead, Garrett.
Hey, Zarek. You've been pretty active on social media as far as the Houston Dash and watching them. What has it been like for you watching them start before you guys did, and what does their performance mean for you and the team down in Orlando?
First and foremost, I think the NWSL has put on an incredible tournament in Salt Lake City. It's been great to see, and I think the competition levels have been fantastic. I'm excited to continually watch the Dash more specifically, as they've been one of the more spoken about and quote-unquote fun teams to watch. But obviously down in Houston, we have a little bit more access to that. And we're a little bit on the front foot in terms of recognizing skill and stuff like that. Obviously, Rachel's had an incredible tournament, and there's been some players that have really been able to step up and make a name for themselves, which is exciting to see. And I think that now the Dash have turned some heads, and suddenly it's one of the organizations that is being spoken about, which rightfully so. And I can't stress enough that my teammates and I are talking about it, and we're excited to see them hopefully move on in the tournament.
Thanks, Garrett. We'll go to Enrique Gonzalez next. Go ahead, Enrique.
Claro que sí. Hola, ¿qué tal? Buenas tardes. Bueno, pues la pregunta es esta, ¿no? Es un torneo que se ha hecho muy parejo debido a que no hay visitantes ni locales, ¿no? ¿Cómo se siente esto en el campo y en qué ayuda también a cómo se desenvuelve el partido? Un 3-3 que al aficionado emociona, pero para el jugador puede ser frustrante, ¿no?
Sí, claro que es un partido y un torneo un poquito diferente que normal. En Houston tenemos una ventaja grande cuando equipos tienen que venir a nuestra casa para jugar, y también nos ayuda si no tenemos que ir a LAFC, donde es un lugar muy difícil a jugar, y también Portland y Galaxy también, pues nos ayuda. Pero mira, cuando empezamos y entramos a la cancha, todo se queda lo mismo. Claro que no podemos tener la ventaja de nuestros aficionados para ayudarnos en los momentos difíciles, pero también no hay que jugar contra 12 personas cuando estamos afuera de casa. Pero para mí, estoy solo feliz para estar jugando partidos otra vez después de casi 4 meses, pienso, sí, sin jugar, y estamos listos para seguir jugando contra unos buenos equipos.
Gracias, Enrique. We'll go to Ian Killen now, please.
Hi, Zarek. Thanks for taking the time today. I appreciate it. I'm here from MLSsoccer.com, by the way. I know you've played for both Gio and now for Tab. They were old teammates back in the day on the original Metro Stars. I wonder similarities and differences for you between their two styles as managers and as people.
definitely there are some similarities, and I think that there are definitely some differences. I think some of the similarities would be they were both attacking players, so they definitely want to enjoy on the ball and also give the players the freedom to express themselves, because that's what they did. Gio was a goal scorer, and Tab was Tab's resume speaks for himself as well. But I think that both coaches want to give the players the space to create for themselves and not give them too many barriers, because as players, they wanted to have that creativity and that freedom as well. I think one of the biggest differences would probably be personality. Tab's a little bit more, I would say, less gif-able than Gio. Gio wears his heart on his sleeve, and he's there, and he's passionate, and he wants to be on the field with you and cheering you on, and you can see that he's in the game. When he leaves, he's sweating, and you know he's been there with you. And obviously Tab's a little bit more controlled and pensive about kind of the way he goes about things. And neither is right or wrong. I think that's definitely one of the things that you'll see on the sidelines. I mean, every game Gio is doing something where people are looking and saying, oh man, that's a coach that definitely wants to be there with his players. And then Tab is one of these guys that, you know, really is knowledgeable, that will pull you aside and maybe not be as outwardly emotional, but definitely has, you know, an incredible knowledge to the way he goes about coaching.
Thanks, Ian. We'll go to Hector Zapata and then to Andres Inzunz after that. Go ahead, Hector.
Hey, Zarek. One more question. This is regarding Memo Rodriguez. Can you talk about his performance in the last game, and also what have you seen in that particular game that made you think, like, okay, this kid is growing, especially what he's being giving to the team, those two goals, especially the second one where you serve that cross. Just your thoughts about how he's evolving with the team.
Memo and I spent a lot of time in the individual training session period of the Dynamo. We have obviously we're split up into quadrants like most teams, and Memo was the player to my right or left depending on the way you were, and we were able to run and suffer and work together, and I was able to see his work ethic from putting in work on fitness. We would challenge each other and kind of have little bets, and then obviously to see the work he put in, whether it was shooting or dribbling, whatever it might be. So to see him put in that work and to dedicate himself to his craft was inspiring. And it just proves that he belongs at this level, and he can really excel and be one of the better midfielders in this league, in my opinion. I am his biggest fan. Hopefully he'll tell you that. If not, maybe his mom might go first. But I'm definitely a solid number two. I think that the sky's the limit for him. As long as he continues to work and put in an effort, which I know he does, he can become an incredible player. And it's great to see that he is reaping the benefits of that. But also he's cognizant of the fact that it's just one game. You know what I mean? He scored two goals in one game, and now he wants to do the same thing next game. And he wants to continually push himself and to enjoy the challenges that come with that. And ultimately, as most people that cross the ball will tell you, a lot of times those guys make you look pretty good. So his run was incredible. Mauro's initial movement helped set everything up, and those guys made my ball look pretty decent at the end. And don't forget Albert doing all the hard work and all the running for me.
Thank you.
We'll go to Andres and then to Ubaldo Martinez after that.
Sorry. Volviendo un poquito al partido, al primer partido que llevaron a cabo contra el LAFC, y sin importar el resultado, lo que se hizo bien o lo que se hizo mal, tú como jugador, ¿cómo te sentiste el volver a entrar a un torneo y poder tocar el balón? ¿Qué sentimiento fue esos primeros minutos que estuviste en la cancha y conforme fue pasando el partido?
Primeramente, yo pienso que, como todos, estuvimos un poquito nerviosos porque no hemos jugado en casi 4 meses y no es como una pretemporada normal que podemos volver y entrar al partido y no cuesta puntos. Pero en el primer minuto tenía que hacer un taco con Kay para salvar un gol. Y ahí está, ¡pum! Directamente, dentro de un minuto tienes que estar listo. Pero yo pienso que entramos al partido bien. Y también, mira, después de 10 minutos, yo pienso que los dos equipos estaban listos para jugar. Claro que es difícil sin una pretemporada normal para buscar minutos. Yo pienso que casi ningún equipo he jugado contra otro, pero mira, como el Dynamo quiere ser un uno de los mejores equipos en la liga, tenemos que jugar contra los mejores equipos en la liga. Y claro que el año pasado LFC fueron Supporters Shield y todo, y jugaron buenísimo, y todavía sin Vela pueden jugar bueno, pero fue una gran prueba para nosotros, y confirmamos con nosotros que podemos jugar con cualquier equipo. Y mira, estoy listo para jugar más, y estoy emocionado como mis compañeros para estar ahí afuera pateando a otras personas en vez de nosotros.
Gracias, Andrés. Ubaldo, go ahead.
Buenas tardes. ¿Qué representa el equipo de Portland, especialmente para ustedes como defensiva, después de que el último partido pues se dejan escapar una ventana, ¿no?
¿Puedes decirlo otra vez? Un poquito del internet estaba ahí difícil.
Sí. ¿Qué reto presenta el equipo de Portland para especialmente para ti como defensivo, especialmente después del último resultado que dejan escapar una ventaja de 2 goals?
Sí, defensivamente Portland juega bien como siempre. Cuando yo estaba ahí, cuando fuimos al final, estábamos primeramente buena defensivamente y jugamos bien de contragolpe. Y yo pienso que juegan un poquito lo mismo como cuando yo estaba ahí. Y hay que estar atentos siempre a dónde está Sebastián Blanco y dónde está Valeri, porque son buenos jugadores y uno de los mejores atacantes en la liga, pero también ellos tienen que estar atentos de nuestros jugadores también, como Mauro, como Darwin, como Memo, y hay Albert, hay muchos que tienen que estar concentrados porque tenemos un buen equipo. Pero para mí quizás sería un partido un poquito más lento que de LAFC, porque los sistemas de ellos son diferentes, pero también pueden seguir con unos problemas diferentes, pero algunos que si jugamos bien nosotros podemos buscar una ventaja, y si todo se va bien podemos buscar 3 puntos y ganar contra ellos.
Gracias, Ubaldo. ¿Una más pregunta? No.
Yeah, I have a quick follow-up, if I may. Uh-huh. Sarek, en español otra vez, tú que representas uh-huh. Dynamo, el sindicato de jugadores, ¿qué tan satisfecho estás tú con la manera como la MLS ha organizado el torneo, tomando en cuenta todos los protocolos? ¿Te sientes seguro con todo lo que se ha implementado en Orlando?
Sí, mira, este mañana tuvimos testing a las 7 de la mañana, está ahí, levantando muy temprano, pero con todo estoy muy feliz. He hablado con personas de la liga, con mis amigos y con gente para decir gracias, porque esto no es fácil. Tenían que construir un mundial en casi 2 meses y eso no es fácil. Hay muchos protocolos y hay muchas personas y hay 26 equipos en 2 hoteles, y claro que no puede ser perfecto. Es difícil protegernos 100%, pero mira, afuera de Dallas y afuera de Nashville no hay mucho peligro, y me siento completamente cómodo acá con mis compañeros, y yo sé que ellos se sienten lo mismo. Y mira, lo más importante para nosotros es jugar fútbol, y como jugador de fútbol no estoy pensando en mi seguridad en este momento, porque me siento muy bien y podemos enfocarnos en el fútbol y solo el fútbol, y eso es lo más importante in at the moment.
Zarek, if I may, just I wanted to follow up on that question in English, just if you can kind of talk a little bit about how you feel with the testing protocols and everything going on in Orlando.
Of course. My answer will be a little bit different, as I can articulate myself a little bit better in English, but obviously as a union member, I was involved in a lot of these calls and the background and everything for the past few months. And I've said that upon seeing a few of my friends and colleagues in the league, I thank them for all the work they put in. They've been working 18, 19, 20 hour days for the past few months, and it's a lot of work that goes into this. And ultimately, outside of Nashville and Dallas, there hasn't been many positive tests, and the players feel safe. This is safer than Houston at this moment in time. We don't have to go to the grocery store. We don't have to leave our houses to do anything here. We can stay in our bubble and focus on the game and focus on our opponents and focus on soccer. And that's the most important thing at this moment. And the fact that we're able to give 110% and we don't have to think about the outside world in that sense is a kudos to the league. Obviously, there are some difficult protocols. We have to wake up early to do testing and things like that. But if you're waking up at 7:15 to have access to testing so that we can play the game we love, that's no problem at all. And again, there's a lot of moving pieces, but credit to the league for putting on this tournament in such quick fashion and being successful with it, knock on wood, until the end of it, which will be early mid-August.
Thank you for that. We'll do one more question. We'll go to Enrique Gonzalez to wrap things up here.
Algo bien interesante que acabas de comentar. En Alemania hubo errores, ¿verdad? Que salían a la calle cuando estaban en concentración. ¿Y cómo se comprometen los jugadores unos con otros, el staff? ¿Hay una comunicación en todos los que están concentrados para no cometer errores y salir contagiados por accidente?
Sí. Hemos hablado como equipo, como asegurarnos, there it is, para estar lo más seguro posible. Mira, si quedamos con nuestro equipo, vamos a eliminar el chance para buscar el virus de otro equipo. Había un positivo en Columbus y pienso el otro fue Kansas City. Y mira, si el Dynamo y mi equipo se queda con nosotros, podemos eliminar el chance de estar ahí cerca de ellos. Y mira, yo sé que nuestro equipo quiere jugar fútbol y eso es lo más importante a nosotros, para nuestros aficionados y para nuestras familias, es estar ahí y tratar de jugar lo mejor posible y ganar este torneo, porque esto es la meta de todo nuestro equipo. Y sabemos, para llegar a nuestra meta hay que hacer unos sacrificios, y nuestro equipo somos muy feliz con nuestra manera de estar acá en el hotel y en el bubble. Pero también hay sacrificios que tenemos que hacer. Y mira, tenemos amigos en cualquier equipo, pero lo más importante no son nuestros amigos en este momento, es nuestro equipo. Y hay que asegurarnos que estamos ahí haciendo las cosas lo mejor posible en cada momento.
Thank you, Zarek. We're going to go ahead and wrap that up here. We need to turn the studio over to the next team since we're all sharing space. So thanks for the time.
No worries. Thank you. Questions.